Good morning, students. Today I'm going to start the new chapter, that is physical and chemical changes. So come to the chapter 7, physical and chemical changes. So come to page number 88. So physical means the external appearance and the chemical means the reactions that takes place. So physical and chemical change, I think you all know. So physical changes can be reversed, whereas chemical changes cannot be reversed. That means in physical changes, new substances are not formed. They will come back in its original substance. Whereas in chemical change, new substances are formed and the original substance will not come back. So that is the main difference between the physical and chemical changes. So come to page number 88. Physical and chemical changes. So chapter focus is given here. Number one, changes and its type. This will be the first topic you will study. Number two, characteristics of the chemical reactions. This will be the second topic. Number three, types of chemical reactions. Number three. Number four, solubility of solids in liquids. And number five, separation of component of solution. So these are the main topics you will study in this chapter. So come to the activity given here. That is the physical and chemical changes, the activity. Effects of changes. So you will take three sheets of paper. In the first, there you will take three sheets. That means the first, you will take first sheet to burn it. Second, from the second sheet, you will make this, you will fold and you will make a shape. And in the third sheet, you will tear the third one into pieces. So out of these sheets, which one do you think can bring back to its original conditions? So see the picture here. So three sheets of papers are taken. First is burned. Second it has given the shape. Third has been tear off to different smaller pieces. So in second and the third case, the paper can bring back, because the first case the paper is burning and it will change into ash. So after burning, no new, paper will remain there, it will change into ash. Whereas second and third, just in second case the paper has been folded to give a different shape, but still it is in the original, it can come back. Even if we are tearing the paper, that means the paper size has been decreasing, not the paper. So the second and the third will have the physical change, whereas the first one will have the chemical change. So we have learned about the physical and chemical change in the previous chapter also, class. So a change is said to be physical or chemical depending on whether new substances are formed or not. So underline this line. A change is said to be physical or chemical depending on whether a new substance are formed or not. So that is about the change. So changes are of two types. Physical change. Physical change is a change in the state of matter or physical properties without disturbing the chemical composition of the substance. So we observe physical changes when wax melts or water boils to form steam. Other common physical changes we observe very frequently are freezing of water, tearing of paper, cutting of clothes, dissolving of sugar in coffee, etc. So most of the physical changes are reversible change. So underline this line, reversible changes. And physical change is a state in the state of matter or physical properties without disturbing the chemical composition of the substance. So this is about the physical change. When two or more chemical substances react to form new substances, it is termed as the chemical change or a chemical reaction. So chemical reactions occurs at molecular level. The substances which take parts in the reactions are termed as reactant, while the substance produce are termed as products. So that means where in the chemical change, what happened? Two or more chemical substances react to form a new substance in a and chemical reactions are in a molecular level. So if A, for example, A is the first reactant and B is the second reactant. So these two will react and will form and form a product, that is C, new product. So what are these? These two are reactant. These two are called reactants. And this one is called, C is called as products. So in the chemical chain, the substance which take part in the reactions are termed as reactant, while the substance which produce are termed as product. And product are chemically different from the reactant, unlike physical changes. So physical change is just different from the chemical change, because physical change is a reversible change and chemical change is irreversible change. That means no new substance will form after a physical change, because it will come back to its original position. Whereas in chemical change, it is a irreversible. That means after the chemical change takes place, new substance are formed, and new substance are entirely different from the reactant. That's why we say in a chemical change or in a reactions, new substance are formed and it is irreversible change. Next page, page number 89. So many things happening around us are examples of chemical reactions. Number one is curdling of milk. Number two, burning of paper, the burning of fuels, cooking food, respiration, rusting of iron, process of photosynthesis, digestion of food, etc. are all processes where chemical reactions takes place and the reacting substances are chemically different from the product. So reacting substances are chemically different, transform into new products. So when milk changes to form curd, the taste also changes, because the sugar present in milk get transformed into the lactic acid. Underline this line. So when milk changes to form curd, the taste changes from sugar to lactic acid. So that's why we say that which acid is present in curd? Lactic acid. And why the curd is sour in taste? Due to the lactic acid. So whenever a chemical reaction takes place, the properties of the reactants after forming the new product are totally different from each other. So that is the chemical change. So some given here the differentiation of physical and chemical change. Physical change, some example of physical change are freezing of water, melting of wax, boiling of water. Chemical change, a few example of chemical change are digestion of food, then the burning of coal, rusting, etc. Physical change is mostly reversible. Chemical change is irreversible. In physical change, no new substance are formed. In chemical change, new substances are formed. Physical change is a temporary change. Chemical change is a permanent change. Physical change involves very little to no absorption of energy, whereas in chemical change, it involves absorption and evolution of energy. And in physical change, it affects only physical properties, that is shape, size, etc. Whereas in chemical change, it affects both physical and the chemical properties of the substances. These are the main differences between the physical and the chemical changes. So you have to learn it. So you have to learn this properties of physical and the chemical change. That's all.